my dearest chess friends, and welcome to my chess channel. This is International Master Camila Ciobanu, and I am so happy to teach you today how to fight for the center. And we will see a game that I so much like. We will see it from Black's perspective. It is about a French defense, and it is a correspondence game that has been played between the 1987 and 1991 between Carniol and Abreu. Let's see the game. So e4, e6, d4, d5, knight to d2, defending the pawn, attacking the pawn twice. And here we are in the French defense with a closed center and two pawn chains. Okay, so what is Black going to do next? He's going to attack the base of that pawn chain, and White will defend the pawn on d4, and Black will increase the pressure in the center. Okay, so White develops the knight on e2, which is a very flexible movement for the knight because it leaves the pawn open. The pawn is way open, so the pawn could go to f4, plus the other knight could go to f3, and so opening up the diagonal of the bishop. Okay, so Black will take on d4 and eliminate the tension in the center, and in so doing, White remains with a weak pawn on d4. Okay, so Black will focus on attacking it, but first of all, he will also attack the top of the pawn chain by pushing the pawn to f6, creating a new conflict. And so White will suddenly take back, and Black is remaining with a weak pawn on e6. It is a backwards pawn on a semi-open file. Okay, knight f3 pointing toward the central square e5, and now Black will develop the bishop and defend it twice, so White cannot enter on it. Finally, queen to c7, creating a battery already that points toward h2. Now you'll see that White will block that diagonal by pushing the pawn to g3, and so it allows the bishop to develop on f4, because White would like to trade his bad bishop for Black's good bishop, and this is what happens. It's just that this costs White some weaknesses on the king side, because the light squares are weak now since the bishop is not developed in fianchetto. So let's see how Black will be able to exploit that weakness. Okay, so Black will focus on attacking the weak pawn on d4, plus the queen also attacks the pawn on b2. And now White has a potential tactical resource. If Black dares to take the pawn on d4, now actually Black is going to lose the queen, yes, after the discovered attack with bishop sacrifice with a check. Okay, so Black would be losing the queen, so Black has to pay attention to such threats. Therefore, he plays a prophylactic king to h8 just to run away from the possible check on h7, and so Black is really threatening the pawn on d4, and the bishop has to retreat. Bishop to d7, rook to e1 attacking on e6 twice, and Black will complete the development by bringing the rook in the center and defending the weak pawn on e6. Queen to d2, and now this is a very interesting position. It is the most important moment in the game, in which Black has a very, very nice opportunity, and he should be able to see what to do next, okay? So since he's attacking the pawn on d4 twice, and White is defending it twice, one option would be to try and bring a new attacker, the third one, but we can see that it would be very difficult to do so, and it would take too much time, and White would simply defend it with rook to d1, probably. So it's not worth it. Okay, so another strategy would be that of trying to distract or send away one of the defenders of d4, and Black will go for this one, because the knight on f3 can be attacked in two moves. How? Well, Black pushes the pawn to g5 and wanting to push it further on g4 and create two outposts on f3 and h3 and send the knight away from f3. And now White will not retreat the knight on e2. That would be too passive maybe, so White what does is take and accept the trade. Okay, knight takes on g5, he takes the challenge, and now black takes the central pawn. So it was convenient for black to give a pawn from the g-file for the central pawn, because look what happens next. They trade queens, and finally black has two pawns in the center, and this is wonderful. Okay, the knight goes back, the knight even goes into fianchetto, and now black will bring the third piece into center. So actually black is invading white center now with his own knight and attacking the bishop, which goes to defend the weak square on f3, but in so doing it just interrupts the communication between the two rooks. And so this puts white into an even more passive position, with his pieces being disposed on the first two ranks alone. Okay, so bishop to c6, bringing the bishop on the diagonal. The knight goes on the side, probably wanting to bring it to f3 and trade black's knight in the center. So it's time to push the pawn and take control of f3 as well as d3. So now black has left the f4 square with no control, so white will go back. Can you see white is just maneuvering? Now he's trying to bring the knight on f4. But black also has a knight maneuver, and so strong, because now he's bringing even the second knight in the center. So the whole center belongs to black, with two pawns and two knights on it. And this is such a rare situation. I'm not sure I've ever seen it before. Probably I have, but I just want to mention that this is one of the best possible setting for any of the players. Okay, so white takes the pawn on e4, and now black has even a passed pawn on the e-file, which white will block with a knight, but it is already late, because now black can invade white's position further on by installing his knight on the outpost on d3 and attacking the rook. And after knight to f3 check, white will have to take, because black is also attacking the knight on d2. And the pawn advances one step more, leaving the knight exposed, attacked by the rook. And when the knight moves away, now in all strength, the pawn pushes forward. The bad bishop has just been opened on the long diagonal, and so black has a winning position, because white is very weak on the first rank. And so actually white resigns at this move number 32. If white was to take on f2, then knight takes, rook check, rook back, rook takes on f1 with a checkmate. Wow, what a beautiful game. And we just saw some basic ideas in the French defense for black. We saw how to attack the pawn chain, how to create weaknesses, and then how to make convenient trades and to fight for the center, occupy the center, and from there just expand and gain more space, and just win in a very nice way, playing with all the forces against white's king. Well, my dear friends, I thank you so much for your attention. Thank you for being here, and I cannot wait to see you in our next video. All the best to you. Goodbye.